In 2006, spin instructor Ruth Zuckerman organized a meeting with her, Julie Rice, and Elizabeth Cutler, which would later be called the best blind date ever. After being suggested to Zuckerman to start her own business with her own style of motivating and working out, she gathered two of her spin students, Cutler and Rice, to help her start her business. In 2006, SoulCycle was born on the vision that you could create a workout class that was both fun and engaging, which was not typical of classes at the time. Even though it could have blended in with the other thousands of spin studios, SoulCycle stood out because they put their instructors on the pedestal and they have a cult-like following. The model is simple. People sign up for classes at the beginning of each week, and there's no membership availability, and every bike in a class costs the same. And that's about where the similarities end with other cycle studios. SoulCycle classes are held in a candlelit room with pounding music and instructors who are yelling motivational affirmations at you constantly. They also do more than just cycling as they engage your upper body, which most cycling classes did not. The ensemble creates a pack mentality of people feeling welcome and joined together in this workout, which is all part of their marketing strategy. But of course, there were some obstacles along the way, and in 2009, Zuckerman actually left SoulCycle to create one of its biggest competitors, Flywheel. This left Rice and Cutler as the head of the company, and just 2 years later, they sold SoulCycle to one of the biggest gym conglomerates, Equinox, and each founder was reportedly gained about $90 million. SoulCycle's growth has closely been related to cultivating loyal and frequent customers and also upselling a lot of things without making it feel forced. For example, loyal riders actually receive invites to special events such as concerts and conventions. And since April 2019, frequent riders are actually able to book their favorite bike ahead before everyone else. The company also created another revenue stream of selling popular merchandise. Nowadays, and under the direction of CEO Melanie Whelan, SoulCycle has been valued at around $900 million. And that's how SoulCycle started. Thank you for watching my video. If you enjoyed it, please subscribe to me on YouTube and follow me on Instagram at AustinDanielPetrie.